ashamed of my religion, and I will answer you with the answer in my book. So, regarding this verse, it is recorded that Abu Sayyid al-Khudri said that he heard the Prophet saying, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Lord will reveal his shame, and every believing male and female will prostrate to him. The only people who will remain standing are those who prostrated in the world life only to be seen and heard, i.e. to be shown off. This type of person will try to prostrate at the time, but his back will be made to be one stiff plate, the bone that will not bend. This hadith was recorded in the two Sahihs, Sahih Muslim and Bukhari, and other books with different routes of transmission with various wordings. Now, in Islam, we have a belief called Asma wa Sifat, the beautiful names of Allah Azza wa Jalla and His attributes. There is a verse in the Quran which says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدُ اللَّهُ السَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ means there is nothing like Him, there is nothing like Allah. So when you say Shem, you are actually comparing the creation to the Creator. So there is no similitude between the Creator and the creation. So this is my answer to you. Now, I have a question for you. Do you believe that the Old Testament and the New Testament are both revelations from God? If so, then how do you explain the following verses that I find to be...
Just wait. You are jumping. So now you agree that Allah, He have a shin, correct? Is that what we understand? You agreed that Allah, He have a shin, and Allah was going to show His shin, correct? Your mind.
Christian friends, I told you, there is no similitude between the Creator and the creation. Let me ask you a question.
It doesn't matter. I'm not asking you if the shin of Allah is like my shin. I'm not asking you if Allah's shin is hairy like mine. This is not the question. Allah have a shin. Allah Himself saying that, not me. I'm not the one who named it shin. It is Allah Himself. If it is not a shin, why Allah name it a shin? Name it zucchini. Allah choose a name for it. A name for a part we have in our body. So we are not asking you if the shin of Allah is made from silicone or from beef or from plastic. Allah's shin is unlike any shin. No problem. This is not the question. Do we agree right now that Allah is going to show His shin? Do we agree? You're mine.
Christian friends, are you a man? Do you have manners? If you have manners, now you have to answer my questions, man. I mean, I told you what I believe in. And if you don't accept it, that's your choice.
You told me nothing. We did not understand. I'm asking you the question. I want the answer in a very simple way. Allah will show His shin, yes or no? Allah have a shin, yes or no? This is the question. Do Allah have a shin? Either you say yes, He do, or you say He don't. Your mind.
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. There is nothing like him. There is nothing like unto Allah.
I know. It's exactly the same when my mom, she told me, you are the most ugly person because you look like Muhammad. No one like me, man. Does that mean I'm Allah? What does it have to do with this? I'm asking you a very simple question. The shin, Allah have a shin, yes or no? I'm not asking you if the shin of Allah is equal to my shin. No, it's not equal. Maybe He have 100 bones more. Maybe He's extremely fat. Maybe it's extremely sexy. Not the point. The point is Allah's shin. Allah have a shin. Do He have a shin? Or He don't have a shin? He would take the mic and again would say, Allah is unlike anything. Allah, no one is equal to Allah. Allah is not like any computer you have. Allah, this is not the question. Allah, do he have a shin or he don't have a shin? Your mind.
In addition to his shell, he has a face, he has a hand. And he has them in the manner that befits his majesty.
Great. So now you agree that Allah, he have a shin. Okay, now let us put the parts together. Allah have hands, Allah have face, and he have a shin. What we have now? Guys, attach the hands to a shin. And put a face in the shin and let us laugh together. Can this be a God? One shin, two hands? You oh my.
Christian friends, did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, teach his followers to mock other people's religions?
Yes, absolutely. He did. Big time. Now answer me. We did put the shin of Allah. Let me try to create what we have right now. This will be Allah's shin. This is will be Allah's shin. Okay? And this is will be, I don't know how to do it. Like you have to use symbolic things to draw it. We have a shin and we have two hands coming out of it. You know what? If Allah have one shin, this is mean he do this one point. Just one shin. What happened to the other leg? Why Allah have one shin? You're mine.
Stupid thing. Good.
Christian Prince, you're just speaking from your, I don't know from where, you're just imagining things, okay? And the Lord that I worship cannot be measured. He is beyond imagination. He is the most perfect, the most almighty, the all-knowing. Now, I don't get your point of mocking me and etc. etc. We want.
I'm not mocking you, man. I'm asking you questions. You cry each time you take the mic. You look like a pregnant woman in the delivery room. Allah have a face. Everybody heard you saying that. Guys, did he say Allah have a face? Did Allah say that? Did he say that? Allah have a face. It means Allah have a back. If he have a face, it means Allah have a back. Because now we are talking not about metaphor meaning. We are talking about a physical shape. Remember, this is not a metaphor meaning no more. We are talking about parts of body. Shin, hands, face. It means Allah have a back. Do your God Allah have a back? Your mind?
Christian Prince, you have asked a lot of questions and I answered most of it I could. Now let me ask you a question. You believe that God exists, don't you? And I believe you do. So if he does exist, how does he exist? Tell me. I'll release the mic to you.
Well, I believe that God exists, but if it's about the God of Islam, his existence is about existence of his shin. Because if we delete the shin of Allah, Allah is gone. Take the shin of Allah, Allah is dead. Allah is just a physical part, a physical body, which is a little shin. A shin. You're mine. Guys, did you hear me? Did you hear what I said at the end? So, are you calling a friend, Mr. Akhi? Akhi, I know nothing about Islam, brother. Don't worry. Be happy. You know a lot more than me. This is why I am in the corner. I cannot answer you, brother. the existence of the shin of Allah is the existence of Allah, because without Allah's shin, Allah doesn't exist. And here we will ask you a very simple question. Why Allah have a shin even? Guys, when somebody have a leg, the leg is to use, to walk, right? Correct? The mouth is to eat with it. The butt is to sit on it. Allah have a shin, why? I want to know why.